Climate change is driving temperatures higher in Los Angeles. Trees can help us beat the heat. But it's not as simple as digging a hole and planting a tree. We need to know what kinds of trees to plant, where to plant them, and how many to plant. Convened by the USC Dornsife Public Exchange, the USC Urban Trees Initiative set out to provide the answers. Findings from the initiative will guide the city's program to plant an urban forest in the Eastside communities of Lincoln Heights, El Sereno, and Ramona Gardens.
When it comes to combating extreme heat, trees are the most cost-effective way of doing that. Which species are the best species, most effective? What are the best investments for our city as it becomes hotter and drier, but we still want to live here?
Trees are a tremendous tool for us to address these urban issues of air quality and urban heat, as well as provide many other benefits like beautifying our communities. So how can we be thoughtful in those investments, and how can we meet the mayor's goal?
We're focused on those neighborhoods that are impacted by the highest temperatures and the worst air pollution. And our partners at USC are also researching canopy inequity and the potential impacts on the air quality near their health sciences campus just down the street here in Lincoln Heights.
The value that we bring to this project is creating a strategic decision-making process, a vision, before we go out there and dig holes and put trees in them. What are the most beneficial trees and where are they needed most?
The partnership with USC has allowed us to take a couple different lenses. We've got the lens of science through spatial sciences, we've got earth science, and we've got landscape architecture, and the community engagement component all together informing each other.
Community involvement was critical in the development of the Urban Tree Initiative. And we found that establishing a dialogue with them instead of a monologue really is going to help the research, and it was really going to help the university move forward, working with not only our local neighbors, but working with our elected officials to develop urban tree canopy that's going to benefit everyone in the neighborhood.
You have large swaths of the city that lack green cover, and green cover is going to bring you benefits in terms of health, in terms of shade, in terms of mitigating air pollution.
We've got a dozen sensors that we want to position around school buildings and let that be part of a network that tells us the quality of air on the neighborhood scale within LA. Behind me is Bravo High School in this study area that we're working in, and this is the location where we'd like to put at least one of these sensors and get some sense of what it means to be in an area that's, for example, rather close to the freeway.
I really want to make sure that we get this right. When we talk about planting 90,000 trees, when we talk about increasing tree canopy cover in our neighborhoods, we want to make sure that we're making really smart investments, that we're not just planting, but that we're thinking about what we want to get from those trees, what urban issues we want to address, what habitat value we want to increase in our neighborhoods.
Planting trees on streets and parks, creating urban cooling with trees is way more cost effective. The only thing is, it takes some time to get those trees to be big enough to create that shade. It's not as quick as building a building.
But with a few strategic investments, you could begin to build destinations, which among other things would bring benefits in terms of social engagement, in terms of active lifestyles, all kinds of things.